published 2244 EDT, the 30th of October 2017 updated 2246 EDT, the 30th of October 2017 Bette Midler threw her annual Halloween party in New York City on Monday. The Broadway star-studded bash was held to benefit the New York Restoration Project at Cathedral of St. John the Divine. In a towering blonde wig redolent of Marie Antoinette, the 71-year-old had draped herself in a green getup speckled with flower and butterfly designs. She posed with her 30-year-old daughter Sophie von Hasselberg, who wore a skin-tight nude jumpsuit that was covered in floral patterns of its own. Scroll down for video family time. Bette Midler posed with her daughter Sophie von Hasselberg on Monday at this year's edition of her annual Halloween party. Sophie, whose father is Betty's husband of 33 years Martin von Hasselberg, had on a massive headpiece shaped like huge colorful flowers. Flowers, whether they were real or faux was unclear, also dotted Betty's hairdo. Playing up the 18th century France look, Betty's green ensemble featured sleeves that flared out at the cuffs just below her elbows. All that sweet affection. Sophie, whose father is Betty's husband of 33 years Martin von Hasselberg, had on a massive headpiece shaped like huge colorful flowers. Retro in a towering blonde wig redolent of Marie Antoinette, the 71-year-old had draped herself in a green getup speckled with flower and butterfly designs. The cause: the Broadway star-studded bash was held to benefit the New York Restoration Project at Cathedral of St. John the Divine. Sheer fabric was wrapped round her apple green corset and fell to the floor. Betty, who won a Tony this year for playing the title role in a still-running Broadway revival of Hello, Dolly, accented the look with extravagant throwback makeup. Ben Platt, who also won a Tony this year courtesy the new Broadway show Dear Evan Hansen, was flashback chic himself, conjuring up the 1970s. Back in the day, Ben Platt, who also won a Tony this year courtesy the new Broadway show Dear Evan Hansen, was flashback chic himself, conjuring up the 1970s. The old look: he left half the buttons undone on his flashy shirt, which featured purple and white patterns across a pine green field. Duo in aviators posing beside him, in a matching pair of sunglasses, was Molly Gordon, who also brought back the 1970s in a frilly red dress. Left half the buttons undone on his splashy shirt, which featured purple and white patterns across a pine green field. The 24-year-old had tucked the top into a pair of white and burgundy checked trousers, popping on yellow aviators and a false mustache. Posing beside him, in a matching pair of sunglasses, was Molly Gordon, who also brought back the 1970s in a frilly red dress. Bombshell in black. Among the other guests was Broadway legend Bernadette Peters, who rocked a massive black ball sleeveless ball gown with pale yellow splotches when you got it. The dress was slightly open at the bust, showing a butterfly-specked undergarment. Ben had posted an Instagram photo of himself and Molly in costume, vamping "We were cut from the deuce" on HBO. The wound is still fresh. Happy Halloween. Among the other guests was Broadway legend Bernadette Peters, who rocked a massive black ball sleeveless ball gown with pale yellow splotches. The dress was slightly open at the bust, showing a butterfly-specked undergarment. Themed. Meanwhile, Skylar Astin and Anna Camp, who got married last year, had turned up in a fun couple's costume. Wayne and Garth from Wayne's World, respectively. Look: Anna had Garth's long, blonde hair frizzed slightly at the front, managed with a wig, and even held a pair of drumsticks in her hand. Uncanny, she added to the look with a purple and white checked shirt left open over a t-shirt, plus a faded pair of jeans and a thick-rimmed pair of specs. Posing with her hands on her waist, the ageless Into the Woods star wore an autumnal headpiece in her iconic curls. Meanwhile, Skylar Astin and Anna Camp, who got married last year, had turned up in a fun couple's costume. Wayne and Garth from Wayne's World, respectively. A Saturday Night Live sketch, then a duo of films, Wayne's World had starred Mike Myers as the title character and Dana Carvey as Garth. Bringing back a legend, Victor Garber, whose Broadway bona fides include originating the role of Anthony Hope in the musical Sweeney Todd in 1979, had dressed as Groucho Marx. Anna had Garth's long, blonde hair frizzed slightly at the front, managed with a wig, and even held a pair of drumsticks in her hand. She added to the look with a purple and white checked shirt left open over a t-shirt, plus a faded pair of jeans and a thick-rimmed pair of specs. Skylar had approximated Wayne's long dark hair with his own wig, popping on a baseball cap and wrapping a black leather jacket round his waist. Biblical Michael Kors appeared to have dressed as the Garden of Eden. His jumpsuit was covered in pictures of leaves and apples, and had a false snake round his neck with his hostess. He held up an apple to offer to the snake, and had worn a red mask with a horn, so it's also possible he was the devil, as embodied in the reptile. His black t-shirt clashed against slightly torn jeans, but matched his black shoes. Victor Garber, whose Broadway bona fides include originating the role of Anthony Hope in the musical Sweeney Todd in 1979, had dressed as Groucho Marx. Michael Kors appeared to have dressed as the Garden of Eden. His jumpsuit was covered in pictures of leaves and apples, and had a false snake round his neck. He held up an apple to offer to the snake, and had worn a red mask with a horn, so it's also possible he was the devil, as embodied in the reptile. Mingling, Betty hobnobbed at the carpet with billionaire Eric Schmidt, whose tail jacket was made of white netting and was worn over a tie-less white dress shirt so glamorous. Also posing up a storm at the event was Dita Von Teese, who sizzled in a netted veil and a black gown with pointed, curved-up shoulders. Betty hobnobbed at the carpet with billionaire Eric Schmidt, whose tail jacket was made of white netting and was worn over a tie-less white dress shirt. His black top hat was ringed with multicolored feathers, and he had a string of large hot pink beads tossed round his neck, rounding out the look with black slacks. Also posing up a storm at the event was Dita Von Teese, who sizzled in a netted veil and a black gown with pointed, curved-up shoulders. Coordinated, her dress had a lacy, sheer section of fabric over her cleavage, and she had complemented it with an intricately designed black choker garnishing the look. Balancing on a pair of black heels, she carried a sparkling clutch. Her dress had a lacy, sheer section of fabric over her cleavage, and she had complemented it with an intricately designed black choker. Balancing on a pair of black heels, she carried a sparkling clutch. Dita was also photographed while sitting at a table at the event, a plate of food sitting in front of her. Refreshments. Dita was also photographed while sitting at a table at the event, a plate of food sitting in front of her.